But how do we address it? How do we address this issue? How do we deal with this? Because it is wrong, but what do we do as a people? What do we do as a community? How do we go about handling this? Yes, we're hurting, and yes, we're going through a lot right now, but we got to ask some questions. How, as a community, as a people, not simply Black, not simply Hispanic, but just us as citizens of America, how do we deal with this problem in our community? Well, let's take a look real quick. If we look at Luke chapter 18, look what it says. It says this. It says, he spoke a parable to them, and this is Jesus speaking, and Jesus is telling a story, and he's speaking about the importance of the persistence of prayer. Yet he uses an allegory or metaphor to explain that. And look what he says. He says, there was a certain city, a judge who did not fear God. This judge did not fear God, nor did this judge regard man. And he says, now there came to him a widow. You have to understand who the widow is. The widow is the disenfranchised. The widow is the one that's left to the side. The widow is the one that's being persecuted. The widow is the one that's being hurt. The widow is the one that's experiencing injustice. And look what it says. It says, there was a widow in that city, and she came to him saying, get justice for me from my adversary. Then in verse 4, he would not for a while. It says he did not respond for a while, but afterwards he said within himself, though I do not fear God, nor do I regard man, yet because this widow troubles me, I will avenge her. I'm not for her, but because of her persistence, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming, she be weary of me. Do you see that? By her continual coming, she will be tired of me. I'll be tired. I'll be weary. She's wearing me out. She's weighing me down. She keeps coming back and forth and coming to me. Two things you got to observe, because I don't want to spend a lot of time on this. Two things that you have to observe. First of all, the judge was not concerned about her. The judge did not care. The judge was apathetic. The judge had no interest in what interested her. He was a godless judge. He was a judge who did not care about her values. But while he was apathetic towards her, she still pleaded. Can I just say this real quick? That you don't need to wait for the law to approve of you to approach the law. No, you have to go and speak. You have to go and talk. You have to go and address it. You don't wait for people to support you. You don't wait for people to be on your side. When you see something is wrong, you need to stand before the court. You need to stand before the government. You need to stand before those who are in power, and you need to speak, and you need to say something. You don't wait till the atmosphere is right or until the situation is right. No, because people may not support you and people may not be on your side, but you must approach them. You must step in front of them. You must step before them, and you must say what it is that you see, and you must plead to them about your case. It don't matter if they care about you. It don't matter if they're on your side. It doesn't even matter if they're for you. It is important that you go whether or not they are for you. Now notice the next thing. The second thing that you'll notice is that even though the judge was apathetic, and even though the first time the judge said no, and the second time the judge had apathy, the third time, we don't know how many times. However, what we know is that she was persistent. Let me repeat that again. What you'll notice is that she was persistent. She didn't wait. If she went to court and she did not get what she wanted, she didn't go back home and sit defeated. If she went before the court of law, or she went before the government, or she went before the senators and they didn't give her what she wanted, she didn't go back home defeated. No, she said, I'll go home, but I'll come back the next day with my same request. I'll continue to come back, and I'll continue to come back, and I'll continue to come back. He's teaching something here. He's teaching that God will bless persistence. God will bless you going out continually every day, every week, every month to declare it and to say that this is wrong, and that what we're going through is not what we should be going through. This is how we win, my brothers and sisters. We don't win by rioting on the streets. We don't win by burning down homes. We don't win by causing a bunch of discord. That's not how we win. The way that we win is we petition. The way that we win is we protest. The way that we win is we speak up. The way that we win is we go to the polls and we go and vote. Some of y'all haven't even gone to the polls. How do you expect to get what you want? And how do you expect to get what it is that you desire for your group, for your people, for this generation?